Praise the Lord, precious church. Praise the Lord. Today, I got a little word for the hearers, whoever tune in to this channel by the grace of God. And today's word is about faith. And the title of this message is, Where is Your Faith? And faith should be in God. In God alone, we trust. The reason why is because everything else can be shaken, and God cannot be shaken. The invisible God cannot be shaken. Everything else can be shaken. Whatever it may be, it can be shaken. So many times when people go through things in this world, and they go through struggles, they go through trials and tribulations, and they go through a storm, a lot of times their faith starts to be shaken. Their faith starts to shake. And the reason why their faith shakes is because their faith really was never really rooted in God. When your faith is in what is unshakable, then you cannot be shaken. Because no one can shake God. God cannot be shaken. But the things of this world can be shaken. The money can be shaken. The house can be shaken. The car can be shaken. Whatever you can think about, the treasures of this world, the possessions that we have, the things that we have can be shaken. Whatever you think of in this life can be shaken. The only and only thing that cannot be shaken is God Almighty. God Almighty, His kingdom. That's the only thing that cannot be shaken. But everything else is shakable. Everything else, the earth, that's why you see earthquakes, you know, left and right. You know, you're in a plane, turbulence, you know, shaking to let you know that these things can be shaken. Cars, you're driving down the road, and here's a pothole, boom, you know, because and the car shakes. You know, it doesn't matter, you know, what it is. It can be shaken. Everything can be shaken. You know, you have a something in the house, an electronic that you use. You know, one, it serves you for a long time, a microwave or a toaster. And then one day you put the bread in there and poof. And then you see a black smoke coming out of it, you know, because and it's done. It's fried because it's shakable. You know, it's shakable. Everything can be shaken. So when we put our trust in what is shakable, what can be shaken, then the minute that thing gets shaken, then we go down with it. Then our faith also gets shaken. So that's why sometimes we have to really test our heart, to really look at ourselves in the mirror and really think and really look at ourselves and look at the reality of it, that when things are happening to us, like when we're going through a storm or when we're going through a trial and tribulation, whatever the storm is that we're going through, if we see that we're being shaken and then we start to lose faith in God or whatever it is, if that's happening to us, that means our faith was never really in God. Our faith was in that thing, whatever the situation, that's where our faith was. So that's why when something gets shaken, sometimes people start to lose their faith in God. That's because their faith was never really in God. Or they believe in God because of something. Really, when you're supposed to believe in God alone, you know, you're supposed to believe in God alone. Without any reserve, like you're supposed to believe in God just for who He is, just God Almighty, because you know He's God, He created all things, He's God, you know. But people believe in things, we believe in stuff, we believe in things, that's where our trust is. That's why sometimes some people, rather than going to God for their healing, you know, some people will straight flat out turn down a prayer, like that. So they'll straight flat out rather go to medicine for healing than to God. Sometimes they don't even believe God can heal them. You know, they'd rather think that they have more of a chance of getting healed by going to medicine than going to God, because their faith really is not in God. Period. Their faith is in medicine. You know, and you know, so what I'm saying is that our faith, no matter what situation we're going through, should never shake. It should never shake. And if it does shake, we should test ourselves. If it does shake, that means we should question ourselves as to where is our faith. Is our faith really in God? Because if it is in God, then we wouldn't be shaken. We'd believe in God. We would believe that God would come through for us. We would believe that our situation is going to change. We would believe that no matter what happens, God is going to still be there for us. We would believe that no matter what. You know, I'll give you an example. And this thing I'm saying is for all Christians. This message is for every Christian. Because this message, I can trace all the way back to Peter. All the way back to Peter, the original, one of the original Christians. The original Christian that was walking with Christ at the beginning. And he was with Jesus. That means he believed in Jesus. But the minute that Jesus put him through a storm, the minute that God put him through a storm, the minute that he saw he was in a storm, he lost faith. And he started to drown when he was when he began to walk on the water. The minute that the storm came, he lost faith. And he began to fall through the water. He began to sink. That's because his faith at that moment, his faith was not in God. If his faith was really in Christ, he would not sink. He would not be shaken. That's because he trusts in that storm more than he trusts in the Lord. He trusts in the power of that storm to shake him more than he trusts in the power of God, Jesus Christ, the rock, to hold him. You see? So what I'm saying is that we need to trust the Lord, because these are some evil days we're living in. We are living in the last days, the days of trial, the days where we're going to have struggles, the days where trials and tribulations will come, the days when the storm will come, because this is the days of testing. This is the days your faith will be tested. You will be tested to see where your faith is at. God will see, will have to see where your heart is. We will be tested so God can see where our heart is. He wants to see where is your heart. Is your heart really with him, or is your heart with all these things out there? It doesn't matter what it is. Where is your faith? Is your faith in your children? Is your faith in your money? Is your faith in your cars? Is your faith in everything, anything that you can think of? Is your faith in that? Where is your faith? Where is your faith? If everything was gone, if everything disappeared in this world, there was nothing left. There was nothing left. How would you still be okay? If you had lost everything, would you still be okay? Yes, you would. If your faith is in God, you would still be all right. If your faith is in God, no matter what the situation is, you would still be all right. Because you know, with God, everything is possible. With God, everything can work out. With God, you can get a new beginning. Because Job lost everything, and God came back and gave him a new beginning and gave him what better than what he had before. You know, because he went through a trial and tribulation, he went through a storm, and he fought to keep the faith. He fought to keep the faith. You know, so the faith has to be in Christ, not in what we have. Not in the possession, not in the material stuff, not in the things that we have. That's not faith. That's not faith. You shouldn't believe in God because he gave you, because you have all these things. You're like, oh, I have all this. You know, that's not the reason you should believe in God. You should believe in God simply because of who he is. Because he is God. And he deserved to be worshipped. He deserved glory. He deserved to be honored. And without him, you wouldn't exist. He's your creator. He gives you the breath of life. You should believe in him. You shouldn't have to say, well, this is what he did. You shouldn't have to attach anything, like any material thing. Like, because when you start to believe in the material things, then your faith starts to be in the material stuff. Your faith has to be in God. So when things happen to those material things, when they start to shake, when the house, the money, all these things start to go away, then you still believe in God. Then you will still worship God. Then you still wake up and praising the Lord in the morning, no matter what the situation. Then you will still give God glory no matter what. You know, in sickness, in good health, and in poor health, you will still praise the Lord. Because guess what? Your faith is in God. Your faith is in God. God, no matter what the situation, God remains God. And he can always take care of you. He can always provide. He can always help. He can always save. His power has not changed. He always has the power to save, the power to change situation. Your situation can always change, but your faith in God should never change. And the message for today really is, again, like I said, your faith should be in what cannot be shaken. Not in this world, not in the things of this world. Your faith should be in God, because God is unshakable. If your faith is really in God, then no matter what the situation, you will not be shaken. But if your faith is in the material stuff, in the things that you have, in your situation, if you have a good situation that's going on, as soon as the situation changes, then you start to lose heart, then you have to test yourself. You have to ask yourself, where is my faith? Where is my happiness? Did my happiness come from the Lord? Or did my happiness come from the things that I have? If your happiness comes from the Lord, if your joy comes from the Lord, from your joy comes from worshiping the Lord, obeying the Lord, magnifying the Lord, praising the Lord, if that's where your joy comes from, if those things that, or those other things, if they go away, it's not going to change you. You will still have joy, because your joy to begin with was with the Lord. So keep yourself close to the Lord. Keep yourself close to the Lord, and do not put your trust on this world. Don't put your choice in the things of this world. Do not trust the things of this world, because one day you can have it and tomorrow is gone, because it can be shaken. The scripture tells you everything will be shaken until what cannot be shaken remains. And the only thing that cannot be shaken is the Lord, God Almighty. That's why your faith should be in God. God Almighty in His kingdom. That's the only thing that cannot be shaken, but everything else can be shaken. Everything in this world can be shaken. That's why when people start to seek the treasures of this world, they start to believe in these things, they start to feel proud because of the things that they have, then the minute that those things get shaken, they also get shaken too, even though they believe in Jesus. They will also be shaken, because really, their faith never really was in Christ. Their faith was in those things. Their faith was in the money that they had. Their faith was in the career or whatever that they feel that makes them feel proud, that makes them feel like God is walking with them. Whatever it was, you know, that's where their faith was. But really, to begin with, your faith should always be in the Lord, God Almighty, Jehovah, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. Because Him, if your faith is really in Christ Jesus, you will never be shaken, because Jesus is the rock. No matter what the situation is, you continue to obey the Lord. That means that you have faith. No matter what you're going through, you continue to pray. You continue to seek the face of the Lord. You do not despair. You continue to obey God's commandments. You continue the pathway of repentance, because through repentance is everlasting life. Through repentance, you receive the forgiveness for your sins, so you can see the kingdom of God. Because the kingdom of God is not for sinners, but it's for people that have been forgiven of their sins, the holy people. You see, no matter what the situation is, you keep your faith. You continue to obey God. You continue to walk in righteousness. You continue to walk in holiness. And if you happen to fall, if you happen to make a mistake, you happen to sin, get back up. Repent. Get back up. Repent. Don't stay down. Get back up. Because remember, in this life, that happens sometimes. That happens as human beings. Sometimes we fall, you know. But it's not. But the Lord says, when that happens, you gotta get up, because He wants you to get up. He wants you to go to heaven. He doesn't want you to stay down so you can go to hell, you know. Because when people stay down, that means they're staying in their sin, you know. He wants you to get up and repent. Ask God for forgiveness for your sins and turn away from it. Don't go back to it. Keep the faith. That's what it means to keep the faith. You keep going. You keep going. It's a race. You keep running. You keep walking. You don't stop. You don't stop. You don't stop because the time is near. The time is near for the coming of Christ. You don't want to stop, especially when you started seeking the Lord. You know, you come this far. You come this far. You can't quit now. Even if you just started, you can't quit. Because you found out the truth about the kingdom of God. You found out that in Jesus, you're going to go to heaven. And people without Jesus is hell. So once you know this truth, you can't go back. There's no going back. There's no going back to the world. There's no going back to sin, because it's not going to help you. Especially when you have found this beautiful knowledge of the kingdom of God, this beautiful treasure. May the Lord bless you. Shalom.